This is a painting which would hang in any gallery in the world. It's a really major painting by a very important and very rare painter.
I think people in Hull have a very exciting opportunity here to see a painting of this standing.
It's just such an exciting and exceptional object of great rarity and great value. The panel painting, Christ Between Saints Paul and Peter, is a really fantastic work. A gold background panel, which is something that we'd been looking for a number of years. 700 years old, of great rarity, the only fully autographed work by Pietro Lorenzetti in the UK. And it tells a story that relates to the very origins of Western art history. Ferens Art Gallery is a public art gallery which opened its doors to the public in 1927, and we display a wide variety of fine art, both paintings and sculpture, and they span from the mid 15th century up to the 21st century.
The Ferens Gallery is always interested in the purchase or acquisition by one means or another of new works that will fit the collection. The John Bradshaw bequest tended to focus us in a specific direction.
John Bradshaw was director of the Ferens Art Gallery. He ran the Ferens Art Gallery for 27 years. He became the man in charge of all Hull museums and art galleries. And when he died, he left a very generous legacy, and he would be delighted, and I think quite flattered, that this has been purchased in his memory.
The painting had actually been sold to an overseas buyer at Christie's in July 2012. So it was definitely going to leave the country. And this is why the government looked at it and a decision was made to put it under a temporary export ban.
Not very long after the stop had been made public, one of my colleagues received a phone call from Kirsten Simster at the Ferens Art Gallery saying that she was very, very interested in coming to see the picture. And I could see immediately that they were very excited by it and by the possibility of trying to acquire it for their collection.
So this painting was worth several millions of pounds, and we got it for about a fifth of its actual market value.
The painting represents three men in niches. We have Christ in the centre, holding up his hand and blessing and wearing these beautiful robes which are covered with stripes of gold. And to his right side is St. Paul, holding a sword. Again, the scabbard is very beautifully painted with details we don't quite understand, but I hope that we can. And on the other side, we have St. Peter, who's holding keys. And the figures originally would have been separated by architectural elements of the painting, which were probably stripped off when it was taken from its context in the late 18th or early 19th century. But there's still a sense of them trying to see each other beyond the boundaries of the niches that they're in. It's rather extraordinary to see that connection between them in an object which is trying to stop them from connecting. I would say in this painting, and in many of his work, the important feature is that he conveys the humanity of Christ and of the saints. They're no longer, like in a Byzantine painting, icons. They're people who seem to be, or seem to be beginning to be at least, to be alive and to be understandable to our world.
Since it was acquired, the painting has been with the conservation studios at the National Gallery with Larry Keith. So it couldn't be in better hands. It's in the right place, and the work will be fully conserved as part of their support for regional art galleries.
Well, of course, when we get a picture like this and know we're going to do treatment, we do a lot of investigative work before we start any actual treatment. So I've got good photography. I've seen infrared images, x-rays, x-radiography, so I've got a quite good idea of the broad outlines of its condition. It looks to be in very good state. The varnishes that are on it are very, very discolored, and it's quite hard to read, but I'm very hopeful that it's going to be something of really high quality and excellent preservation. The next thing is to embark on the cleaning itself and to do a few test cleans and understand the properties of the varnish. After cleaning, we're faced with a picture that probably has a need for some retouching of old damages and losses, and then we'll arrive at a consensus view about what kind of retouching is appropriate for those losses and do the restoration.
What's important about the restoration of this painting is that it will enable people to really appreciate its quality. It's difficult to see that when it's covered in layers of varnish and dirt, but really underneath this we're looking at a remarkable survival, a painting that's almost 700 years old and yet takes us back really to the dawn of the Renaissance.
I think the big gains from the treatment in terms of what you see on the surface will have to do with removing the discoloration from the varnish layers. And you can get a sense of what kind of transformation that means from areas where it's flaked off here. You see very little varnish and more of the brilliant gold here and here. Also the kind of interference and noise of the discolored retouchings from the architectural elements or along the bottom, that will all go. And then you'll see a much more vibrant image where the individual colors and the relationships between them will be much closer to how it would have been previously.
There's quite a lot of evidence that this painting was originally part of a larger collection of panels, what we would call a polyptych or a multi-paneled altarpiece.
The bottom contour you'll see is very jagged where it's been sawn, and there's a lot of damage, paint loss around that saw mark, and hence this whole sort of perimeter band of discolored retouching. The fact that the wood grain of the principal part of the panel, the main panel, runs vertically on a piece which you now see in so strongly a landscape format is also indicative of the fact that it probably belonged in the context of something much bigger with a vertical orientation.
It's a work of art from Italy which will become synonymous with Hull for possibly hundreds of years.
I think this will greatly enhance the status of the Ferens. I mean, the Ferens has some major pictures, some really good pictures, but I think this now becomes the star piece.
It's going to be an exciting time over the next 10 months, but obviously we don't have the work here, but we'll be following its story very closely. And when it does actually come here, it is going to be a fantastic moment for the art gallery to be able to actually display this work and to invite the public through the doors to come and see it.
What will happen after restoration when it brings out all the true colours and is cleaned, as it were, it will be a magnificent specimen. I still can't believe that Hull's acquired it.